Hello, and welcome to this episode of Case Bites. My name is Rob Scheidegger, and today I'm going to be talking to you a little bit about X-ray solutions in the team medicine environment. Before we get into the presentation today, I want to just share a little bit about myself. I'm an athletics healthcare administrator with over 20 years of experience in professional and Division I athletics. I started off my career at the University of Washington. I was the head football athletic trainer there and moved into an administrative role before coming to the Seattle Mariners and working as the director of health and performance for the Seattle Mariners. I have over 20 years of experience as a certified athletic trainer providing team medicine services, but I also have over 18 years as a licensed X-ray technician. This is a really important piece of my qualification and experience because it's a big part of our game day, being able to provide X-ray services both during practices and at games is a really important piece of providing team medicine services. I have no disclosures. I work only just for the Seattle Mariners and not receiving any funding from any other companies. The thing I want to talk about today is the solution that I think a lot of athletic trainers and people in my situation have to deal with, and that is sort of deciding between quality and accessibility when it comes to your stadium X-ray solution. I think we're going to get into this in a little bit, but I think generally just understanding what options there are out there. I know traditionally there's been sort of one singular solution for stadium X-ray, but now there are many different solutions, and healthcare professionals that provide team medicine services need to know these options and be able to choose the best solution, the one that's right for them in their setting. Before we get into the specifics of providing X-ray services at a stadium, I just want to talk a little bit about X-ray and just do a basic brush up on just sort of the fundamentals of X-ray. So as everyone knows, X-ray machines create invisible radiation, high energy electromagnetic radiation to be specific. These waves are produced by the X-ray machine and passed through the body into a detector, which is placed on the opposite side of the subject from the machine. Different density elements in the body allow different levels of X-ray exposure to reach the detector. Then the computer can process this and create images which can be utilized for diagnostic purposes. In the traditional stadium X-ray model, these units take up an entire room. When I first came to the Seattle Mariners, we had a full room X-ray machine that was utilized on game day. Obviously, X-ray in the particular setting I work in is really important because it's mandated by the Major League Baseball that all teams have the ability to provide X-rays on site for both the home and visiting team. When the stadium was built back in 1999, they allocated an entire room for X-ray, and there's some real advantages to the traditional full room X-ray setup. These machines are going to produce the highest quality images and give you the most versatility in what types of images you can actually produce. So you can see in this photo, there's a standing bucky, which allows you to take standing films. This is the easiest way to take a lot of upper extremity films like shoulder, cervical spine, thoracic spine, even standing weight-bearing lower extremity x-rays like the knee and ankle. The drawback to the traditional stadium x-ray is it's the most expensive solution. Replacing a unit like this that was dated the way ours had been over the past 20 years would have been really, really expensive. The most expensive that we're going to talk about today. In addition to cost, they take up a lot of room. A lot of times in stadiums, space is at a premium, especially with the way sports medicine teams have grown over the years. The athletic training rooms and strength and conditioning spaces in particular have gotten smaller and smaller as the staff has gotten bigger and bigger. When we were looking at replacing our traditional X-ray system a few years ago, this was a big factor because there was a lot of different reasons why we wanted to recapture the space from our stadium training room, which was currently being used for X-ray. So we looked at a lot of different solutions because we wanted to make sure we were doing the right thing, not only for creating high quality X-rays and continuing to provide that mandated service, but also to utilize our space in a really functional and thoughtful way. So we looked at a few different options that I'm going to go through and sort of explain to you guys today. The first and sort of most space-saving option was a handheld X-ray. There's an example of a handheld X-ray in the photo here. Obviously, as you would expect, these devices produce the lowest quality images. But on the flip, they're the least expensive and have the smallest space requirement. There's several different models of these out there, but we felt like for providing the services that we were looking and the quality of image that we were going for, this wasn't a great solution for us because we did have the space to have a little bit more investment in space and wanted a little bit higher quality film. Many stadiums across baseball utilize a C-arm. C-arm X-rays are really, their advantage is actually in the ability to capture motion images. So you can see on in the photograph here, the receiver is actually built into the X-ray device. And so it's always there. You don't have to move and set up the receiver underneath or behind the extremity that you're trying to take an X-ray of. You can obviously have this built in, and this machine can run, and you can take a motion image of a body part and get sort of multiple views without taking multiple images. The drawback to C-arm X-ray is that it's the lowest quality image because of the ability that it has to do this in real time. They're moderately expensive, and they actually take up quite a bit of space, as you can see, because of the lack of functionality in having the receiver built into the unit. However, some people really like the ability to do sort of motion images and be able to look at bones in real time. So this is definitely something worth considering. For us, we really were looking for a device that had this type of mobility, but that could create higher quality images. And so that's why we really dived into the last category, which is a full-scale mobile X-ray solution. This is an example of a really good mobile solution. It's called the Micro-X Rover. This device has a completely miniaturized full X-ray tube built into it. So you're not sacrificing any of the quality that you would have to sacrifice with the handheld options and with the C-arm option, but you're still getting the full versatility of a mobile unit. This device, as we're going to get into in a minute, produces extremely high quality images. You're not limited in what body parts you can take X-rays of with this device. And the cost is actually a little bit less than that of the C-arm X-ray, and only a little bit more than the handheld options, and significantly less than a full room solution. The device that we ultimately decided upon here in our setting is the Micro-X Rover, and it's because of a handful of really, really big beneficial things that this thing can do. First and foremost, its portability and the flexibility that you have with this device is unmatched. It's completely mobile. It actually is self-propelled, so it's really easy to move around. There's a minimal amount of radiation loss, so you don't need a special X-ray room to utilize this device. It can be rolled into an athletic training room, a doctor's office. We can take it over to the visitor locker room and safely perform X-rays, which obviously kind of gets into one of the other real big benefits of the Micro-X Rover, which is patient comfort and safety. The ability for them to be where they are, and we can move this device without having to transport the athlete, really, really makes a versatile and safe environment for athletes to get their X-rays taken. Obviously, this is a really good space-saving device. We have this stored in our athletic training room in a corner. So rather than having an entire room dedicated to X-ray, we can move this device and take the X-rays wherever the athletes are in a safe and functional way. In addition, it provides us with a faster diagnosis because of real-time assessment abilities. There is no processing of films that has to take place in a separate area. This device has a screen built onto it, which does instant processing and has a fully interactive interface. So a physician can actually be observing at the time that the X-ray technician is taking the X-rays. And if they would like to add an additional view, we can do it in real time rather than taking the images, processing them, having the physician review, and then have to come back and bring the athlete back if an additional view is necessary, we can do that in real time. The image quality is really equal to that of the full room devices, which I'll show you in a second. It's very cost effective, and obviously the environmental impact. Lower energy requirement with this device than the full room systems, which obviously is really important in this day and age. Here's some photos of the device that we use in our setting, the Micro-X Rover In Action. You can see in the bottom right-hand corner, the machine is just set up in our treatment area where we typically see our athletes. The receiver is just sitting on the table. And so this would be an ideal setup for a knee or a lower extremity, ankle, foot, hand. We can have the patient seated and put their anything that we're x-raying right in between the device and the receiver. Really comfortable, can bring this to the athlete where they are. And then you can see in the top right corner, that's the visualization of what you're going to actually see. The physician can zoom in, they can make different edits to that in real time, and then decide if additional views are necessary. And then obviously it can save these, and they can be packed into the system for review by radiologists, and then obviously to be kept in the patient's file. The photo on the left shows the upright solution. Again, this device is capable of taking standing x-rays. This is an ideal workaround for obviously cervical spine, shoulder, standing weight-bearing knee and ankle, and any other sort of lower extremity images you want to take with a patient standing. This is portable, fully portable, so we can set this up wherever the patient is. That upright bucky is on wheels, so you can take that anywhere you need to go and still be able to take full standing and upright x-rays with this device. So this was an excellent solution given everything that we were trying to accomplish with replacing our unit once it became time for us to look at updated models. We considered the full room, but wanted to recapture that space so that we could utilize that in a better way. We looked at handheld options. Ultimately, these for us weren't right just because we were looking for something that could produce higher quality image. The C-arm x-ray wasn't the right option for us because, again, looking for higher quality images and more versatility, this device that we ended up choosing allows us to still take cervical, lumbar, rib x-rays, things that the C-arm just simply isn't capable of doing. It isn't designed to do. The Rover allowed us to completely replace our full-size x-ray room. We were able to capture that space, use it for other things, and still not sacrifice quality or patient comfort in providing x-ray solution at our stadium. Again, my name is Rob Scheidegger. Thank you for attending this episode of Case Bites. I hope you found it helpful. We'll see you again soon.